yet in a long time. So have some fun.
This Dyna is the product of 30 years of my experience building high-performance Harley-Davidson FXRs, Sportsters, and Dynas. And not just my experience, but 35 years of George the Horsepower Man Sierczewski, who designed the engine and built the motor to spec. This is the bike that proved to me a Dyna can be better than an FXR.
These bikes have thunder in them.
What's happening, guys? It is January 20th and about 45 degrees today, not bad.
Happy to be out for a ride on the Dyna. If you know Harley-Davidsons, you know that pretty much all Harley-Davidsons are judged by the FXR. The legendary handling of the FXR was light, great turning radius, great lean angle, raking trail was on point, and it handled awesome. This is the FXR of Dynas. It has the sharpest steering rake, 28 degrees, of any Dyna ever made, and the tightest rake and trail, which is 4.1 inches. So the 28 degrees rake, 4.1 inches trail. So it handles amazingly. The shower forks are fully adjustable. You can see the compression and rebound adjusters, compressions up on the top along with the spring preload. The Olin shocks are fully adjustable. And if you know a little bit about Dynas, you know that they're prone to, stock Dynas are prone to wobbling at speed. This thing is rock solid at 120 miles an hour, straight as an arrow. All you gotta do is crank up the compression adjusters a few turns, and she's it's like it's on rails. Now, I'm not gonna demo that today because I still have my court case pending for my Harley-Davidson drag racer video that I did on the Sportster drag racer I built for Junior. So I don't want to get arrested again, or any tickets, so I'm going to just drive normal on here. But I can tell you from experience, this thing's rock solid at well over 100 miles an hour. It's also super comfy. The Sundowner seat, the two-up seat I have, is a big comfy seat. I rode it all the way up to Americade. You could ride all day long in that seat. It's an 8-hour seat all day long. And it's super comfortable on the highway, and the motor is right in the meat of the power band at around 80, 85 miles an hour. With the fairing on the front here, it blows the wind right over you. It's just a perfect setup for long distance sport touring. So, and it's a very versatile bike. Set it up like it is right now for one-off sport riding, or put on the saddlebags. The Leather Pro saddlebags are, as I said earlier, very expandable. You can pack a whole weekend's worth of stuff, his and hers, one on each side. The backrest is awesome. You can put a duffel bag on the back, and you're pretty much good to go for long distance traveling. Get where you're going, strip it down, and you got yourself a sport touring bike. So now, this thing pulled just under 100 horsepower in the dyno and 110 foot-pound of torque. These Bigby Twins are, it's all about the torque. It pulls like an absolute freight train, and it's just a joy to ride. The engine is tuned to perfection by George Sajowski, dyno tuned. This is probably, he's built hundreds of these twin cam motors. All the components work well together. All of them are proven for long range, long mileage, low maintenance. And it's an absolute hoot to drive, and that's what it's all about. This thing, the maneuverability with these Michelin Scorcher 31 tires is fantastic. Of course, you want a 19-inch front wheel. A 21-inch front wheel is not the hot setup for sport riding. This thing's got a great lean angle, sticky tires, the best suspension money can buy, and 100 rear wheel horsepower with 110 foot-pound of torque. Just fantastic. A lot of fun in the twisties like this. A lot of fun on the highway. And that's what it's all about. There isn't a new Harley made today that'll give you the riding performance at this will. There's not a new Harley made today that puts down 100 rear wheel horsepower. The 110 Dyna is about, well, 82 horsepower according to the same dyno I tested this one on at 98.79. So we tested them back to back. This has got substantially more power. Better brakes than any dyno also, because these brakes are off of the touring bike. They're a much upgraded system that came off the 2017 full dresser. We're up here at the tower. Beautiful, crisp winter day. Look at that. Isn't that beautiful? If you come to the museum, you can fly into Bradley International Airport, which is over there on the horizon. Take an Uber over, about a 25-minute ride, and come to the museum. If you buy the bike, pick it up. Come up here to the tower, take some photos. You can leave the bike here as long as you like. We'd love to have this on display in the museum, so if you want to just leave it here till the summertime and come pick it up. Free storage for this one. We normally charge $50 a month, but not for a special bike like this. Again, this is a no expense spare build, using all the best components by the best in the industry. Ohlins, Thunderheader, Screaming Eagle, Michelin Scorchers, all the best of the best. Performance machine and genuine Harley Davidson. As far as the pegs go on the back, I have the Moto X style pegs for the passenger, which Christy loves, and I think they're awesome. I put those on the front, and the flat pegs like that with a size, any, I have a size 12 boot. I got a big foot. I couldn't shift well with that on, so I bought a brand new set of these OEM original Harley Davidson, the skinny rubber pegs. They are, listen, I have all the pegs in stock. I tried them all. This is the best setup. If you're not going to just look at the bike, if you're going to ride it, these are the pegs you want for aggressive sport riding or touring. And nothing like having the highway pegs to stretch out, and you're good to go. Everything works perfectly on the bike. Electrically, the bike's a 10. Mechanically, it's an 11. And cosmetically, it's a 10. It's stunning. Original paint. Trying to encourage me to do a wheelie. I can wheelie this thing, but I can also get in a lot of trouble because, like I said, the cops watch our videos now, and the previous fire chief told me he used to watch all of our videos. Bill, he's no longer with us. Listen to that thing. Listen to that thunderheader howl. You know, talking to George, on the dyno, the Thunderheader puts down the most horsepower. He said, as far as pipes go, it's a real personal preference. Whatever you like, the style for your bike. But if you want one that's going to perform and sound awesome, in my opinion, and I've tried all of them. On my other CVO Dyna, I had the Vance & Hines long shots, the short shots, a Bassani Road Rage 3, and the Thunderheader. Guess what's on it now? Thunderheader. All three of my Dynas have Thunderheaders. If you're wondering why I'm selling this one, well, we've got a ridiculous amount of overhead at the museum. Matter of fact, $36,000 in taxes in January, $10,000 in electrical repairs. We burned through $95,000 in the month of January so far. Just ridiculous how much money we spend here. And I've got three kick-ass Dynas. This is the best, most ready to go one. The other two are still kind of being perfected. I have a 2017 Dyna S that I'm building, so I can't keep all three of them. And we need to come up with some quick cash for the museum. So this isn't the first time I had to sell a bike that I'd much rather keep. Just a fun bike. Chrissy and I, if you're riding a passenger on a bike, this is the ultimate setup. Almost 6 inches of rear wheel, high quality Ohlins shock, totally adjustable for the passenger. Just click the with your fingers or any tools, just click the compression knob a couple turns when you put a passenger on the back, with a backrest so she's not gonna fall off, with cleated pegs so she's gonna feel safe and planted on a big, comfy, top of the line Harley Davidson saddle. So there you have it, folks. Best handling Dyna ever made. They have not made a Dyna that handles better than the FX-DX or the FX-DXT. This is the epitome of Harley Davidson sport touring, with the long travel suspension and the killer brakes and the sticky tires and a 100 horsepower motor. If you're thinking of buying a kick-ass Harley, hit the buy it now button, or build one yourself. Buy a regular DXT like this in real nice shape. They're going for $8,000 to $12,000 for a clean stock one with low miles like this, and then build it yourself. 6 months later, you're gonna have a $30,000 hole in your pocket, I promise you. This one, a ride off into the sunset, knowing it was built by the best in the industry, using nothing but the best components, and it's perfect. Full provenance on it, low miles, only 5,000 miles. Kick-ass machine. They don't make the Dyna anymore. They only make the Softail, so these are finding low mileage ones that are set up right and not hammered on by kids or neglected by old guys is getting to be a hard thing to do. What's happening, Junior? What are your thoughts on this kick-ass machine? How's it sound?
Yeah, I rode this thing for the first time over the summer. We went down to Redding. It's about an hour round trip, and I had Shaylin on the back and with the tour pack, everything we needed for the day, and it was killer, man. Lots of power, lots of passing power on the highway. Riding really aggressively, and I like the feel. It's got brand new Michelin's on it, super sticky. So, I mean, what's it got, like 1,000 miles on it, on like a complete rebuild?
It's got a less than 1,000 miles on the full rebuild.
Essentially, it's a
everything's brand new. The motor, the suspension, the tires.
But not only that, it's an extremely valuable and rare collector's piece. It's not just a kick butt rider. It's a real investment quality piece, and it's a classic now.
The production stats are 472 for this year. We had three of them at one of our events. One of the local MCs rode up, wow, and they had two of them, and they were highly modified. So to find one with original paint like this, original forks, swing arm, everything original, intact, with very low miles, that's an absolute time capsule. Even the original handlebars is, a tall order.
You know, there's going to be a point in time where we look back in 10, 15, 20 years and the value of the bike would have been double what we're going to sell it for at the present day. We're going to be kicking ourselves a little bit, but
it's true. Unfortunately, that's a massive building, and we've got massive bills to go along with it, so we can't keep them all. And this one's done, and it's perfect, and it's ready for a new home. So if you have any questions about it, give us a call, 860-454-7024. Good luck bidding on it. I'm going to take it for one last spin up the road, and then she's going in the driveway. Actually, she's going in the museum. So any other footage you want to get of it, or you think you got everything you need?
Yeah, man, meet me in the first floor.
First floor with this? All right. We're heading in.
compression release, hit those two buttons, makes it easy on the starter, fires right up. Just an amazing piece. What's up, guys? Ken Kaplan here on the first floor of the New England Motorcycle Museum with what is and has been for a while now my favorite Harley-Davidson. This is the very rare, only one of 472 made. I believe it may be one of the lowest production numbers of any of the dynos. This is the FX-DXT. The FX-DX has long been known of as the performance dyna. The T model here took it to another level. It had everything the FX-DX had, plus it had the adjustable front fairing and the removable saddlebags, which I'll show you how that works a little bit later. This bike is a rare survivor. Most of these were ridden into the ground for a bunch of different reasons. Well, they're a blast to ride, number one. Number two, they're fast and they handle great, and they're sought after by the motorcycle club members, stunt riders, and long-distance touring folks. So to find one like this, when I found out this bike became available last year with only 2,900 original miles, and went to look at it, and it was in a heated walkout first floor of a house with a sliding glass door with two layers of carpeting underneath it. It was on carpeting with carpeting on top of carpeting, and it was absolutely immaculate. I fell in love with it, and I called my friend George Sojowski, the horsepower man. You'll see, if you look through the videos, we've done this is probably the most fully documented build of any Dyna or FXR I've built in the 30 years I've been building them. And I think it's probably the most fully documented one that you'll find on the internet today or anywhere in the country or in the world. This bike,
without a shadow of a doubt,
there's over 3 hours of footage that is gonna be in this ad here. So look down and watch. If you're serious about buying this bike, follow the metamorphosis from mild to wild. We took about a 6 month period to build this bike. George Sojowski has been building, I've been building Harley-Davidson FXRs and Dynas for 30 years. I've done dozens of them. George has built hundreds, maybe thousands of the twin cam motors. He's considered to be the twin cam guru, certainly on the East Coast, possibly the best in the country. So I got with George and I said, okay, actually, before I bought this bike, I asked George, I said, I want to do a few project bikes with you this year. We did a Dyna S, we did a CVO Dyna, and we did this one. I said, George, I want to build the ultimate Dyna. What should I do? He goes, well, you got to get a 2000 or a 2001 FX-DX or FX-DXT if you're lucky enough to find one. Sure enough, a couple weeks later, I came across this one, and I made a deal with the owner and took her home. Called up George and asked him, he asked me what I wanted to use this for. I said, well, I want to be able to take it to Daytona, Laconia, ride it up to Americade. I want it to be great on the highway and to be super reliable. So there's a lot of reasons why he said this model was best. We'll get into that later, but on a high level, the rake and trail on this thing, it has a 28 degree rake with 4.1 inches of trail, and it has a very sharp turning ability because of that steep angle on the front end and the short amount of trail that it has. It's also lighter than some of the newer dynos, and it has a better lane angle. So as far as the engine goes, the twin cam 88 is considered by George and many engine builders to be the best one to build because it has the thickest engine cases and the best bearings on the crank, and George will get into that in a later video. So George spec'd this thing out using mostly Screamin' Eagle parts. It's got a Screamin' Eagle 95 cubic inch cylinder and piston kit, high compression piston kit, 10.5:1. And he took these heads, basically we took the bike right down to the frame. Tank, seat, swing arm came off, forks came off, and the only thing left was the engine block. The weak link on the Dynas has long been known by many to be the motor mounts, front and rear. So a bunch of different shops make a different one. George likes the CCE, so we went with the CCE rear motor mount and front motor mount, which is in a later video. You can watch the details in there. And of course, we totally redid all the suspension too, with high performance Olin shocks in the rear. So the engine started life as an 88 cubic inch. It's now the 95 cubic inch Screamin' Eagle big bore kit, brand new complete kit. The CCE front motor mount, the CCE rear motor mount, it has OEM, a new set of OEM Harley-Davidson heads that are the 2006 and up model heads that George decked The 2000, why do we use the 2006 and up heads? Well, it has better porting, a better valve angle, and better valve springs. It's just a much better head than the previous models. And he decked the head to raise the compression ratio and machined manual decompression valves in both cylinders to ease the starting compression, because now it's a big bore with 11:1 compression ratio. So you can see these are the, right here, you just push, hear that click? They automatically release once you start the bike, makes it much easier to start it, takes all the stress off the starter. So the entire engine has brand, all new engine gaskets and seals, new head gasket, new base gasket, new shifter seals, all primary drive and transmission seals and gaskets were replaced on the tire motor because he had it all apart. Didn't really need that. It only had 2,900 miles on it, but why not refreshing it while you had it apart, of course. So it's now a 1557 cc, 95 cubic inch. The cylinders are black. It has the, again, the 10.5:1 compression, Screaming Eagle pistons, piston rings, top end bearings, wrist pin, and circlips. It has a new Screaming Eagle SE257 cam. That's the cam he said to use. He built this so that it would be extremely durable and go 50,000 miles with no issues whatsoever, no matter how hard you ride it. This the engine's, you can't kill this thing. It's bulletproof. So it also has the part of the SE257 cam kit, he put the heavy duty cam bearing assembly and the Screaming Eagle orange anodized hybrid cam plate with the upgraded plate tensioners. He put the new perfect fit push rod kit on it and a Screaming Eagle high performance oil pump, a new Daytona TwinTech TC88 external ignition module, and a Screaming Eagle heavy breather performance air cleaner kit. The CV carb was jetted for the Thunderheader system and the heavy breather. It has a brand new intake manifold, new spark plugs, and of course, a brand new Thunder header. So the entire engine has been completely set up. I have the dyno sheet I can show you in a second. Let me just dig that out. But before I get to that, we also converted to chain drive. Check out the chain drive conversion on this side. The chain drive conversion from the stock belt included a 51 tooth rear sprocket, a 23 tooth countershaft sprocket, the spacer and the pulley, and the top of the line gold chain. I don't know if the video picks up the gold chain, it's beautiful. So the entire engine and running gear was upgraded. Here's the dyno report. We took it up there. There's an actual video of the dyno run that we did. It put down 98.29, where is it here? 98.78 rear wheel horsepower with a torque of 109.67. I want to put that into perspective. The fastest dyno ever made from Harley Davidson out of the box pulled 82 rear wheel horsepower on the same dyno. That's the Dyna S. How do I know that? We took a stock Dyna S and we tested it on the dyno there. That's in another video on our channel you can see. So this has 17 more horsepower than the Dyna S, which was the, and probably 20 foot pound of torque more. I also, while I have the paperwork out, I'll show you, I have the title right here. Good, clean Connecticut title. No issues whatsoever. It's had the same owner since 2003. So this has only had two owners since new. And the mileage, I think I'll note in the first video, you'll see that there was a Buell that was also purchased by us from the previous owner. That Buell had the same amount of miles, 2,900 miles on it. Why did they have the same miles? Well, he rode with his wife. So he babied this thing. He was riding with his wife and he was a middle-aged guy. It wasn't a club rider. This thing's absolutely immaculate. I think the pictures in the video do it justice, but when you see it in person, it looks even better. So the next thing we did, once the motor was completely built, putting down 100 horsepower at the rear wheel, or 98.7 rear wheel horsepower, and the engine motor mounts were all set up, we put a brand new set of mid controls on here because he had the forward controls on. Mid controls are where it's at. These are all brand new Harley Davidson items. Then we ordered the highway pegs and had them painted black to match the rest of the bike, so it looks awesome. So a lot of the other components were painted black. A lot of the stuff was blacked out. Anything that was chrome on the bike was blacked out, either from the factory or we did it, so including the forks. I guess we'll go to the suspension then. Starting at the rear, it's got a brand new set of Ohlins black line, top of the line, adjustable for compression, rebound, and spring tensioning. That combined with the rigid mount, much better motor mount, and the brand new Screaming Eagle Scorcher rear tires, and the new rear brake pads. This thing stops on a dime. The rear, everything is totally dialed in, and it hooks up like crazy. So over to the front of the bike, these are the original. These only came on the FX DXT or the FXDX. These are the fully adjustable for spring preload, compression, and rebound. So you can dial this in for street solo riding, canyon riding, cross country. You can have it soft or you can have it stiff for whatever you want to do. So the forks, let me get over here to the front fork section. Bear with me a second. The cartridge adjustable forks were removed, dismantled, and rebuilt using 40 millimeter fork spring spacers and new heavy duty Race Tech fork springs, brand new seals, new heavy duty 20 weight oil. And we set the oil height at 128 millimeter from the top, and the compression and rebound clickers were set in the middle. The fork lowers were stripped and painted to match the rest of the bike. So the forks are about as good as a set of Harley Davidson forks you'll ever get. So new tire on the front, Michelin Scorcher on the front, that's brand new. The brake system is entirely new. It has a brand new high performance complete brake system. I think I wanna add, when I first rode the bike in the first few videos, the one thing that I thought was a missing link on this is the brakes. The brakes were, the stock Harley brakes, frankly, left something to be desired. And I felt were probably one of the, besides the suspension, the brakes was one of the main things that really needed upgrading. So George found out and has been doing this on a lot of his bikes. You can pull the calipers off the brand new full dressers. These are off a 2017 full dresser. They're a major, major upgrade over the stock calipers. So we ordered brand new front rotors, brand new front calipers, new braided stainless brake lines, and a brand new master cylinder. So the entire front brake system is, I'm gonna say the stock system on a scale of 1 to 10 was like a 5, and these are a 10. These brakes are absolutely amazing. And when you're putting down 100 rear wheel horsepower with 110 foot pound of torque, you need brakes. So brake system's all totally dialed in. Going to the controls, let me pull this part up. The new running gear and controls has new Harley Davidson Dyna S style blacked out clutch and brake levers. Those are brand new. The stock ones were aluminum. These are blacked out. Has new Harley Davidson Dyna S style black mirrors. Has new Performance Machine black Harley Davidson grips. These are absolutely my favorite grips for performance Harley Davidson. New Harley Davidson highway brackets and matching rubber foot pegs. New mid mount controls, Harley Davidson OEM. It has a new Harley Davidson shift lever, new Harley Davidson rear brake lever, and new Harley Davidson foot pegs. So all of the running gear is brand new. And on the back here, This was for Christy, my girlfriend, on my Hot Rod FXR. She actually flew off the back one time last year when I was riding a wheelie. She actually flew off the back. So these foot pegs right here will keep your passengers' feet from coming off the pegs. And I also, right now, you're looking at this bike set up for solo riding. I've got the top of the line Harley Davidson two-up seat, a backrest, and the saddlebags. And I've got the calling card of the FXDXT is the Dyna Superglide Sport is removable saddlebags. We'll get into that for a second because this bike has two personalities. This is a stripped down club style look, if you will, or road racer style look. And then I've got the touring look, and it only takes a second to change everything. So the passenger pegs, again, are the Flow style, Flow MX passenger style. The fairing is a brand new black painted JD Customs FXDXT fairing with a smoked 16 inch screen. That's adjustable. I'll show you in a few minutes. It has the Harley Davidson quick detach backrest and mount kit, which is over here, sitting on the floor over here, and the Harley Davidson Sundowner two up saddle. And also the saddle that's on it on the bike now is a Harley Davidson branded Dyna Solo saddle. And it has the Leather Pros quick detach mounts and saddlebags. So when you put the saddlebag kit on, you have to put the relocation return signal kit and a new license plate bracket and wiring. So on top of that, the bike went through a full rotisserie style 10-hour detail wash, wax, polish, buff the aluminum, touch up the frame. Everything was done. It was worked on by Doc, our number one detail guy, for almost a day and a half. So everything's polished to perfection.
And that was this week, so the bike's fresh. It looks, well, straight out of the Harley factory.
In addition to the fork lowers, the air cleaner, the foot peg mounts front and rear, and the battery cover were all painted black. So this bike cost $15,378 out the door in 2001. There's over $19,000 invested into the bike on top of the initial purchase prices, a total of $35,000 in parts and labor invested on this bike. There's $6,000 into the motor and exhaust. The on the engine build, using all original Harley-Davidson engine Screaming Eagle parts, less than 1,000 miles on the motor since we completed it this summer. I took it up to Americade and rode it around, had it dyno-tuned, and that was designed and built by Moroni Harley-Davidson's master engineer, the horsepower man, George Sajowski, as I mentioned earlier. The conversion to chain drive was about a grand for everything with labor. The high-performance brake upgrade system was $1,800. New tires mounted and balance was $500. The rear shocks were $1,400. The front suspension upgrades was $700. The new running gear and controls was $1,000. It has original handlebars on it. And then the fairing was $550. The quick detach backrest and mount kit was $575. The Harley-Davidson Sundowner 2-Up saddle was $380. The Solo saddle was $225. The Leather Pro quick detach mounts were $150. And the Leather Pro quick detachable saddlebags were $550. So it all adds up with all of the everything that was done with $19,000. So again, the best performing Harley-Davidson Dyna chassis ever made, the most durable Harley-Davidson Dyna engine ever made, and the most flexible setup with the mid controls with highway pegs. The windshield is adjustable to go straight up for touring, and of course the seat and saddlebags. So let me show you quickly how easy it is to convert this thing to a tourer. How long it takes to convert this from solo sport bike to a two-up touring. All you gotta do is remove the thumb screw from back here, pop the seat off, put the Harley-Davidson Sundowner two-up touring seat on, screw in the thumb screw. You don't even need any tools to do this, that's the best part. It's the coolest thing ever. Now, this bike came stock with saddlebags, but the original Harley-Davidson touring bags left something to be desired in Leather Pros. This is the third rendition of the Leather Pro bags, and the mounting system's pretty damn slick. You just pop the bag on and then tighten it down. That's it. And they're totally expandable. You can definitely, we went up to Americade this summer with this bike. Christy and I did, and we went up and packed everything we needed for the whole weekend in the saddlebags, and there's zippers on it. You can expand it so they go way out. There's way more room than you'd get in a full dresser saddlebag. Go on to Leather Pro's website, and you'll see they're pretty awesome. Super easy to put on, and they're lockable. So if you've got a lot of valuable stuff in there, if you're going in a bar or something like that, a Daytona, you can lock these on here so they won't come off. But they're super quick to detach, you just pop them right off. About as easy as it possibly could be. And then you pop your luggage rack on. If you price these components separately, it's $575 from Harley-Davidson. They don't give these away, I'll tell you. And you gotta get the one that's specifically designed for this bike. You can't just get any old one. They're specific to each model. That's it. Voila, touring bike. With all the screwing around, 2 minutes. So what I have here, this is my personal leather touring pack. I've used this on the last few bikes I've had. It's super nice. You can put a lot of stuff in here. I can actually pack my gym bag in this thing. It goes over the backrest right here, and you just Velcro it on, and it's got a another strap that you put around the bottom. But with this on here, you can absolutely pack as much stuff onto this thing as you can on a full dresser. The bags have more room than a full dresser. They expand about that wide, and then you can pack a bunch of stuff in here. So pretty easy to do. Just takes a couple minutes, and it's awesome. It's Christy and I had a blast taking this thing up to Americade last summer, and no one's going to keep up with you on the twisties on this unless they're on a R1. That's for damn sure. These things are incredible. The best handling Harley I've ever ridden. In fact, this is the bike that proved to me a Dyna can be better than an FXR. This is just an incredible machine. And I thought I'd never say that. I've been an FXR guy forever. And the FXRs are awesome for stunt riding, but for long distance touring, there's nothing like a properly set up Dyna. It definitely is as good as the FXR.